Well, when I first came and visited Evergreen, the eggplant was out in a little shack thing in the middle of Red Square. And I was like, what's that? And I was with my friend and she was like, oh, that's the Flaming Eggplant Cafe. They serve organic and locally sourced food on campus. And I was like, no way, because you can't find that. Like at a lot of campuses, it's just like, and especially for such a small campus to have such a deep involvement with the type of food movement that we need to see happening on campuses really excited me. And so I went and got some of the food and it was really good.
Started initially as a registered student organization out of student activities right over there in the CAB building. And so it had kind of a student leadership structure and had advising support from some of the advisors like Andy Korn, Assistant Director of Student Activities and so on. And then through that, the students realized that there was enough momentum on campus that people wanted to see student-run food service. So it grew from this kind of educational group into actually getting the idea to do this full-blown business in a cafe.
Again, saying like we don't want these corporations as part of our food service. So in 2003-2004, we organized a student group called SOFA, Students Organizing for Food Autonomy. We started a petition as like the first step to say we, the students, want Evergreen to look into going self-op, like running their own food service, and stop contracting out.
So we have different committees. We have the finance committee. We have the working party, which does like hiring and training and logistics and things like that. We have the ordering committee, which is broken up into all the different people who do ordering for everything from the cups and compostables to the different food items, the coffee, whatever. We also have a food quality committee that manages the consistency and the quality of food, and they come up with specials and plan the menus and whatnot. So we all make decisions together in one way, and it's not concrete, our jobs. There are certain areas, but it's pretty fluid. And if there's anything we're not sure about, we bring it up as a discussion in a meeting or something. We've definitely created space where it's structured for us to get through time, get through things in time, but we let it be flexible.
Because we have collective meetings every Monday where we have to discuss problems and make decisions collectively, I think it's really helped with my communication skills as a human being. It's also helped me just like think of things in terms of the good of the group rather than just like my own personal opinions.
Mostly what I've learned too is like, for example, with a proposal, you come into the group with an idea and that's now the group's idea. That's not your idea. And you don't have to defend it. I mean, to a certain extent, you don't have to, it's not necessarily yours, it's for everyone. And it's really awesome to come into a group with an idea that you thought about so much and you thought that it was like great and then it gets even better. And it's amazing. It's really cool. And I didn't know you could lose yourself in that kind of thing. Just like being able to lose yourself as an individual in a group and feel good about it, not feel challenged by it or like it's a competition. Yeah.
these are like, it's those things that make me keep coming back to this job. It's really stressful and a lot of work, but it's like, I can really see the effects of how we're like putting a lot of money into local economy, helping local farmers and local food producers be able to maintain their way of life. I know like when we started buying salmon patties, the person told us that we were basically like doubling his income for the year because of the amount that we were able to buy from him.
As the produce order this year, I have developed relationships with local farms. And by local, I mean they're at farthest a 20-minute drive from the restaurant. And we have kind of a unique position because a lot of the farmers that we buy from sell to co-ops and farmers markets. Well, recently we had a tomato bruschetta special, and it was made. I bought 100 pounds of heirloom tomatoes, and we turned it into bruschetta, and then it's served on top of a San Francisco Street pita bread, and then it has Calliope Farm delicata squash roasted on top, and so it's about as local as you can get on every level.
And the basic philosophy of the eggplant, as far as I see it, is that we try to serve local nourishing food that is socially responsible as much of an extent as we can be. We also try to present like a space on campus that fosters political dialogue and makes students think about the greater food systems around them, as well as supporting other radical and political causes. Well, I think we want something that's pretty accessible for people, so, and we definitely like to highlight ingredients that are from the Northwest and prominent in the Northwest, like salmon, for example. We attempt to strive for assertive flavors without being too dominating. I think over the past couple years, our food has improved a lot, and our flavors have gotten more consistent, and people are really putting like passion and energy into like making the food taste really good, which I think is really fantastic. So I find myself in a leadership role at points, but I've also found myself learning from people who have very little kitchen experience, which has been really empowering, and like tossing ideas off each other and really feeling like we're working on it together, which has been awesome.
I like the eggplant because it's run by their students. I have my friends who work here and they make me sandwiches and it's super cute.
The Goron is a falafel pita with the addition of all the contents of a tempeh sandwich.
The hot sauce is really good. I usually tend to get the tempeh grizzle.
So it's really good.
I really like the special that they just added.
And it makes your bones strong.
It was like the grilled eggplant with bruschetta on grilled flatbread.
And it's cheap. I can afford it.
I love the tempeh grizzle because it's delicious.
And it makes you have invincible powers. That's the best part about it.
But that was probably my favorite thing. Okay, the fritter fritters. Definitely the fritter fritters.
I went to a conference on cooperatives, and one of the major things I took away from that was that, especially at this time when we're sort of facing this economic crisis and everything's falling apart due to our capitalist process, really functional cooperatives like the eggplant have sort of an obligation to present themselves as functional co-ops and tell people that that really is a way that we should be turning to, right? And that it works. It's not just like a hippie drum circle pipe dream. Like, we make money, we offer jobs to students. Like, I get incredible work experience. I'll walk away from this job knowing how to do ordering and menu development and all of the like prep cook and line cook and barista and cashier skills that any other job would offer.
I know, I've worked here since we opened. And like I said, I was starting organizing for something of this nature that happened since 2003. But I often don't think about it. Like, I mean, the day-to-day of the cafe takes up so much of my time that it's hard to think this is all started as us coming up with a stupid acronym based on the fact that we had a couch with wheels and asking people to sign a petition.
some things that the students talk about is really creating a community space and a place where students want to hang out and feel comfortable to be, a place for art, a place for shows, a place to get amazing food, a place to learn about food. And then I guess the final piece is that, you know, sharing the story and connecting with other co-ops. I think the students, as the Flaming Eggplant, you know, continues to be more solid and sure of itself and things are kind of being more stable, then I think that there's opportunity for students to connect with other students, inspire and support each other, and build the larger food movement. Roll on tumbleweed, let the wind blow through you, don't you feel like stumbling? Lessen the stress, northwest blessed by the evergreens. Evergreen trees, have you ever seen trees as serene as these? Northwest blessed by the evergreens, we never dream of settling our tethers to the scenery. Yeah.